Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission System. And this is lecture number 3.1. We are going to discuss on the design of chain drive. So, the earlier lecture we discussed the design of flat belt and V belt, and we solved problems on the flat belt and V belt using the design data book. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the chain drive, types of chain drive, advantages and disadvantages of the chain drive, design procedure of the chain drive using the PSG design data book. The learning outcome to the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve explain the design procedure for the chain drive using the PSG design data book. Chain drive. Chain drives are used to transmit power between two parallel shafts comparatively at a longer distances. The chain drive is in between belt drive and the gear drive. So, the center distance is less than the belt drive and the greater than the gear drive. So, the chain drive. So, this is the example of the chain drive, diagram of the chain drive. We have the chain and we have two sprockets. Larger sprocket, it is called as wheel, and smaller sprocket, it is called as pinion. And this is the, how this is how the chain is working. So, the power is transmitted from one sprocket to the another sprocket by means of the chain drive. And the larger sprocket is called as wheel, and the smaller sprocket is normally called as pinion. So, depending on the speed ratio required, any one of the sprocket will act as a driving wheel. Another one is will act as a driven wheel. So, this is again the chain drive, the animated view of the chain drive, so that the students will get the clear idea. So, this is very popular. We have the two wheeler cycle. So, in the two wheeler and the cycle, we have the, of course, two wheeler, we have the power to be transmitted from the engine to the wheel, and in the cycle also from the pedal sprocket to the smaller pinion to the wheel, we have the chain drive. Chain drive consists of two sprockets and an endless chain. The smaller sprocket is called as pinion and the bigger one is called as wheel. The sprockets are toothed wheel of special profile for teeth. The types of chain, there are different types of chains available: bush chain, roller chain. So, bush chain, bush roller type, bush roller with the bent plate, hooked link and the stud link. So, these are all the different types of belt. So, this is the bush roller. Bush roller means the roller, this will roll. So, the pin will roll. So, bush general bush type of pin, chain, and this is the bush roller with the bent plate. So, we look at the plate connecting the adjacent pins, it is bent, and this hooked link, and this is called as stud link. These are all the different types of chains available. And these are all the components of the chain. So, we have the pin link. So, we have the pin, and the pin is attached to the roller by means of press fit, and we have the roller link. We have the, and here we have the slip fit, and this is the roller link plate, pin link plate. So, we have the plates. So, this is roller plate, this is the pin plate, alternatively we have, and this is the one component of the chain. And this is the bush and roller chain. So, the cross section of the bush and roller chain, this W1 is the width, DB is the diameter of the bush, and DP is the diameter of the pin, and W2 is the width on the other side. And similarly, silent chain. So, this is the silent chain, components of the silent chain, and this is the diagram of the sprocket, different types of sprocket available for the chain drive. The chain drive, they have simplex, duplex and triplex roller chain. Simplex chains consist of length of the chain, single link, a single strand, and the chain number with a prefix R and B. We have R some number. So we will see the data book so that you can understand R and B. R for roller chain and B for bush chain. Duplex chain consists of length. So look at the, this is the single strand chain. This is the duplex chain and this is the triplex chain. Depending on the power to be transmitted, we select either the single strand, simplex, duplex or the triplex type of chain. Duplex chain consists of a length of chain of double link, so double strand, and the chain number with the prefix DR and DB. Similarly, triplex chain consists of length of the chain of triple link, triple strand, and the chain number with the prefix TR and TB. This is the different types of roller chain. And the chain characteristics. So we have different types of chain, silent chain, bush roller, bush roller with the bent plate, hook link, stud link. And normally a particular chain is used for the pitch millimeter, the specification, and pitch velocity, velocity ratio, and application. Silent chain, main drive in various machines, bush roller for motorcycle, bush for general motorcycle, bush roller with the bent plate for heavy duty application, hooked link belt for agricultural machinery, and stud link belt chain for drives with under impact loading. So depending on the application, we can select at a particular type of chain. And we discuss some of the effect, polygonal effect or the caudal action of the chain. When the chain passes over this bracket, as we have seen in the animation, it moves as a series of chords instead of continuous arc as in the case of belt drive. So in the belt drive, it is continuously running over the pulley, but here it is chord, it moves series of chord, result in varying speed in the chain drive. So the phenomena is called as polygonal effect or the caudal action. To reduce the caudal effect, so caudal effect will have the variation in the speed ratio of the drive. To reduce the caudal effect, the number of teeth on this bracket should be increased. Number of teeth on this bracket affects the velocity ratio during its rotation through the pitch angle. So the recommended minimum number of teeth for smooth operation is 17. So the number of teeth should be minimum 17, and the higher number like 19 to 21 will give better life to the chain with lesser noise during the operation. So depending on the application, we can select the number of teeth 17 to 21. Then backsliding of the chain. The wear of the chain result in the elongation of the chain and increase in the pitch length. So when the chain is continuously working, because of the stress, because of the wear, there will be elongation. This makes the chain to ride out of the sprocket teeth, resulting faulty chain sprocket engagement. This is known as backsliding of the chain. So this you may have some experience on this when you ride a cycle. Sometimes you may find that chain will be running out of the sprocket. So this is because of the elongation of the chain, and that kind of phenomena is called as backsliding of the chain. And galling. So adhesive wear or galling occurs when the minute points on the pin and the bushing contact surfaces are micro welded together. As the surface interact during the articulation over this bracket, the welded point is turned away as a particles of wear. Because of the wear, the welded point will turn away. Chain pins can become galled if the film of lubrication is unavailable or ineffective. When the lubrication is ineffective, so there is a possibility of galling. So galling means the pins are the weld will open. So weld will turn away. That is what called as galling effect. Operations of chain for short period under extreme load or excessive speed could cause the incipient or moderate galling. So commissioning and maintenance procedure are therefore critical to ensure that the chain is not subject to adverse conditions. So we have to lubricate properly to avoid the galling effect in the chain drive. The advantage of the chain drive are preferred for medium center distance. One chain can be used to drive many units. So the efficiency is higher, 98%. Lower maintenance cost if properly lubricated. So when you apply proper lubrication, the maintenance cost is less, transmit more power and occupy lesser space compared to the belt drive. They can operate under adverse temperature conditions. So whereas the belt cannot do that. So belt material will be getting damaged due to the temperature, but the chain, it is made by metal, so it can be operated at adverse temperature conditions. They do not exert high pressure on the shaft and the bearing. They permit high speed ratio 8 to 10 in one step. So high speed ratio is also possible. So the high speed ratio is not possible in the case of belt drive. Disadvantage, good alignment of shaft is required, especially for high speed chain and wide chains. High cost compared to the belt drive, because it is made by material and there are minute component, the production cost is also high for the chain drive. The failure in the chain, there are three different types of failures: chain elongation, failure of joint and the plate due to the dynamic loading, wear of the sprocket teeth. So these are all the some of the images of these, the failure in the chain. So this is due to the wear and the opening. It is because of the crack due to the overloading, and here again you find a crack due to the overloading, and this is called as elongation. So the because of the load on the pin, so the opening, the there is a gap between the pin and the corresponding fitting component. So this is called as elongation of the chain. It is also due to the overloading. And this is again the example for the wear on the pin and the plate. And this is this is called as galling. So this is for the weld is removed. This is called as galling effect. So the pin is coming out of the plate. And this is what the sprocket damage in the sprocket. So this is a new sprocket. It is worn out. Wear marks are there. You have to change at this condition. Or this is called as overuse. You look at here, the teeth is bent here because of the overloading. And this is again a bush, damaged bush. So these are all the different types of failure occurring in the chain drive. So we have to properly lubricate and maintain the chain to avoid such a failure in the chain drive. Now we take the design procedure for the chain drive using the PSG data book. First step, you have to determine the design power, which is equal to rated power into service factor. So the service factor K is equal to the product of 6 factors. So all the 6 factors are given in the page number 7.76 and 7.77. K1 is the load factor, K2 is the factor for distance regulation, K3 is the factor for center distance, K4 is the factor for position of the sprocket, K5 is the lubrication factor, and K6 is the rating factor. So load factor, so constant load 1.0, variable load or load with mild shock 1.25, load with heavy shock 1.5. K2 value, factor for center distance regulation, adjustable support. When you have adjustable support 1.0, drive using idler sprocket 1.1, fixed center distance 1.25. And the factor for center distance sprockets, K3, AP, so is less than 20 times pitch. So AP is the center distance, so P is the pitch. When this is equal to 1.25, when AP is less than 20 times pitch is 1.25, AP is 30 to 50 times of the pitch, it is 1, AP equal to 60 to 80 times of the pitch, it is 0.8. So when you have, depending on the center distance, we can select 1.25, 1 and 0.8. Factor for the position of the sprocket K4, inclination of the line joining the center of the sprocket to the horizontal up to 60 degree 1, if it is more than 60 degree 1.25. Lubrication factor, when you have continuous lubrication it is 0.8, drop lubrication 1.0 and periodic lubrication 1.5. And rating factor, single shift 8 hours per day 1, double shift 16 hours per day 1.25 and continuous running 1.5. So we have to take, depending on the condition given for the operation of the chain, and we have to take the K1, K2 up to K6, and we have to calculate the service factor. If the conditions are not given properly, we can comfortably design with properly stating the assumption for the selection of the factor. And they determine the transmission ratio. The equation is available in the page number 7.74. So I equal to Z2 by Z1. So Z2 is the number of teeth on the sprocket wheel, and Z1 is the number of teeth of the sprocket pinion. So which is also equal to small n1 by n2. N1 is the speed of the pinion, and n2 is the speed of the wheel. Then preferred is transmission ratio. So this is also available in the page number 7.74. So we calculate the I value, then take the nearest standard value for your further calculation. Then based on the power transmission ratio, use the select type, based on the power transmission ratio and use, select the type of the chain, roller chain or bush chain, a number of strands, and note down the specification of the chain. So for this, you have to refer the PSG design data book, page number 7.71 to 73. So all the design details, all the details of the chain are available. We have to select a single strand, double strand, or the triple strand chain. You note down the chain number and note down all the specification. Pitch length millimeter, roller diameter millimeter, width between inner plates millimeter, Q breaking load kilogram force, and W weight per unit length kilogram force per meter. All these specifications we have to note down. Then select the number of teeth on the pinion and calculate the number of teeth on the wheel. So for select the pinion, we have to refer to page number 7.74. So for transmission ratio I, depending on the transmission ratio, we can take the number of teeth on the sprocket Z1. So once you have the Z1, then you can calculate the Z2. Z2 is the number of teeth on the wheel. So calculate the pitch circle diameter PCD of the pinion D1 and wheel. So D1, pitch circle diameter of the pinion, pitch divided by sine of 180 divided by Z1. So P is the pitch and Z1 is the number of teeth on the pinion. Similarly for the wheel, D2 equal to P divided by sine of 180 divided by Z2 in millimeter. So Z2 equal to number of teeth on the wheel equal to I into Z1. I is the speed ratio, Z1 is the number of teeth on the pinion. Calculate the pitch line velocity. So V equal to pi D1 N1 divided by 60. So we calculate the pitch line velocity. Then tangential force due to power transmission. The equation is available in the page number 7.78. So PT equal to 102 into design power in kilowatt divided by pitch line velocity meters per second. So this is in kilogram force. Then calculate the centrifugal tension. So this is also available 7.78 page number. So PC equal to W into V square by G, where W is the weight of the chain per meter. Weight per meter of the chain, page number 7.78. V is the velocity, pitch line velocity, and tension due to the sagging of the chain. So these equations are also available in this page number 7.78. PS equal to K into W into A. So where W is the weight per meter of the chain and A is the center distance. Normally we take 30 to 50 times of the pitch. If the value is not given, we take 30 to 50 times of the pitch initially. And K is the coefficient of sag. So we have to refer to page number 7.78 for K value. Then actual factor of safety we have to calculate, N equal to Q divided by PT plus PC plus PS. So Q is the breaking load of the chain, so which is taken from the data book. PT, PC and PS we have calculated in the previous slide. So the value what we calculate, the factor of safety, should be greater than the allowable value. So the allowable value is available in the page number 7.77. So you refer to page number 7.77. And the value what is there in the page number 7.77 should be greater than, this value what we calculate should be greater than what is available in the data book. Then calculate the bearing stress, sigma equal to PT plus PC plus PS divided by W into DR, where W is the width of the belt, width between inner plates in centimeter, and DR is the roller diameter in centimeter. So this is given kilogram force per centimeter square. We have to calculate the bearing stress. The value should be less than the allowable value. So the value what we calculated here using the equation should be less than what is available in the page number 7.77. And calculate the length of the chain. So the equation is available in the page number 7.75. LP equal to 2AP plus Z1 plus Z2 divided by 2 plus Z2 minus Z1 divided by 2 pi whole square divided by AP. So where AP equal to AO by P, AO is the initially assumed center distance. So what we calculated earlier. Now this is the length of the chain and the value is to be corrected to the next even number. So once you calculate the LP value, this is to be corrected to the next even number and length of the chain. So page number 7.75, L equal to LP into pitch. So the LP is calculated, taken the next even number into pitch, what is given in the data book. So LP into P is the length of the chain. Then actual center distance, now we have to calculate. This equation is available in the page number 7.75. A equal to E plus square root of E square minus 8M divided by 4 into P, where E equal to LP minus Z1 plus Z2 divided by 2 and M equal to Z2 minus Z1 by 2 pi whole square. And this M value we can calculate using this equation or using the page number 7.76, we can directly take the value of M for the given value of Z2 minus Z1. Then we have to give the allowance for the center distance to accommodate the initial chain sag. So refer to the page number 7.75. So delta equal to 0.01 times of A. So this in centimeter. Then once you calculate everything, write down the specification of the drive. So here again we have to calculate the different parameter using the procedure what is specified here. There are 16 steps in the procedure. And as I told earlier design, all the information, all the data, equations, everything is available in the data book. You have to know how to use the data book for solving the problem. So once you know the data book, correct proper page and proper equation, if you pick up the proper equation, proper data, you will end up with a good design on the component. So these are all the books I have published in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to it. For additional information, you can use the YouTube video channel for updated videos in the subject for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification subject. We'll meet again in the next video with a few problems from the unanswered question paper on the chain drive.